Hello there. Nice to see you again. I'm here with my son Steve. It's his 30th birthday tomorrow. Hi. And we are going to have some oysters tonight. We picked up a selection of oysters from One Fish, Two Fish in Langley, BC. And we want to figure out what wine we want to drink with them. We have the Muscadet, the Unoaked Chardonnay, and the Sauvignon Blanc. The Muscadet is, I better read the label, is the Cuvée du Haut-Censy Muscadet Sèvre et Maine sur Lee. It's a 2009. It's a 2009 silver Unoaked Chardonnay. And the Sauvignon Blanc is from Prospect Winery of the Ganton and Larsen in BC, and it is a 2010. So we're going to sip on the Sauvignon Blanc, the Chardonnay, and the Muscadet to see which we like best with the oysters, right?
Yeah, that's okay, right.
So let's take a sip of the wines first.
Okay.
And see if you have any
reactions.
Impressions. Yeah, okay. Reactions. Yeah.
Sounds good.
First one.
Well, it smells nice.
Good.
It smells like a light mm-hmm. drink.
It's nice.
Delicious.
Yeah, it is delicious, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's got some minerality, it's got nice acid on there. You can tell it's really going to clean your palate.
Yeah, definitely. And I find that it's a light taste.
Mm-hmm.
It would go well, I think, with any kind of dinner, especially mussels, but we'll have to see.
Or oysters.
Yeah, or oysters.
Okay.
I've lost some blood from the shucking. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Thank you, dear. What I have here, this is the Chardonnay. Let's take a smell and a sip. And what is what comes to you?
There's some fruit here.
Mm-hmm. What kind of fruit?
Kind of like, I find apples.
Yeah,
maybe.
Yeah.
And
apples, pears.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's really creamy and rich, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I find it's got like a full flavor to it.
Mm-hmm. It does.
Yeah.
And even though there's no oak on it, there is this smoky element to it.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Yeah.
You know, it's I don't have the taste to know the difference between the oaked and the unoaked.
Yeah.
But I mean, there is a full flavor to this that I quite enjoy.
Okay. And now the Sauvignon Blanc.
Okay.
You notice there's all these little bubbles.
Yeah.
In there, and that's it's not typical of Sauvignon Blanc.
Oh. That's good.
It's got some classic flavors and aromas.
Yeah.
You know, a little bit of green grass, some citrus, and what I really get on the nose,
yeah,
those banana candies.
Oh yeah.
That's what comes to me. So
I do notice the citrus in it though.
Mm-hmm.
It has the three of these here I find that are light flavored,
mm-hmm.
you know, and not overpowering at all. You know, you'd find they would probably go with a selection of different food incredibly also.
Well, you're just dying to get it.
I know, I'm just dying to get at the oysters.
Okay. So so let's do that. Let's pick an oyster.
Okay.
And put either do it plain or put whatever condiment on it
you
want, and then have a sip of a wine and then try another, etc.
Okay.
Let's see what we like best.
Okay.
So I've got the Kusshi oyster here.
Okay. I have a tendency to like horseradish with my oyster.
I'm going to put some lemon on it.
Okay. A little Worcestershire.
Mmm.
Mmm.
Nice. Oh, lovely. Mmm. Lovely, steely.
Yeah.
Briny.
It pairs well with it really well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No kidding, huh?
It definitely does.
Okay, so let's grab another oyster. I'm going to go for the Kumomoto this time.
Well, that's the type I tried first, so I'm going to go with the middle kind here.
That's the Effingham.
The Effingham.
And I'm going to do lemon again.
And he was right, the gentleman at
One Fish,
at One Fish Two Fish,
uh-huh.
That the smaller oysters have a more of a sweeter taste to them.
Oh, okay. Because you've cheated already, haven't you?
I know, that's right. I'm going to try a little seafood sauce on this one.
Mmm. Ooh, I like that.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, which one? I want this one.
Mmm. Oh, that was a great pairing with the silver.
Yeah? You like
yeah.
that?
the bold flavor of the oysters mm-hmm. with the full flavor.
So it's a bigger flavored oyster
that's
and
right.
a bigger flavored wine.
Right? That's right.
And that's what you try to do with wine and food is you want to pair the boldness, if you will.
Yeah.
Right? You don't want the wine to overpower the food or the food to overpower the wine.
Definitely. Yeah, they seem, right. to, they seem to complement each other quite
let's
well there.
Let's do one more. I'll do an Effingham.
Okay. I'll do the first kind here.
Although I got to tell you, I think I'm a little more partial to the little ones. Shell.
Oh, that's great. That's terrific. I had this kind.
They all work, don't they?
Yeah.
They all work. My favorite?
Mm-hmm.
And I haven't tried each oyster with each wine, but my favorite is the Muscadet
okay.
with the oyster and a little bit of lemon.
Excellent.
So far.
And my favorite pairing was with the silver.
Silver?
Yeah.
The Unoaked Chardonnay.
The Unoaked Chardonnay with
Kumomoto.
Yeah, what happened to be with the Kumomoto, yeah.
Okay. Hey, season's greetings.
Thanks a lot.